Advanced maths and its applications such as machine learning or optimization would be ineffective and quite frankly dull if you could only work upon univariate problems. Linear algebra provides the data types, the tools, the operations and the theory to enable the use of multivariate datasets and multivariate models. I used the terms univariate and multivariate but forgot to define them. So basically, univariate involves the analysis of a single variable, while multivariate analysis examines two or more variables. For example, you might study a group of college students to find out their average GPA, or you might study a group of diabetic patients to find their mean weight. Such analysis needs univariate data, that is a single variable, which in our case is the GPA of the student or weights of the diabetic patients. Now, suppose you have to predict the sales of a company. You cannot simply say that X is the factor which will affect the sales. We know that there are multiple aspects or variables which will impact sales, like production capacity, geographical location, competitors, and multiple other variables. Such analysis needs multivariate data, that is multiple variables. I'm sure now it is clear why majority of the problems in the real world are multivariate. Linear algebra is all about data types, their properties and operations that can be performed on them. Data types are containers for data. They are named according to their capacity. A scalar is the most primitive data type. It is a container for a singular value. A vector is an ordered list of scalars. A matrix is a collection of vectors. And very simply put, a tensor is a stack of matrices, or you can also call them as multidimensional arrays. Let's understand these data types in a little more detail. We know that scalar is a container for singular value, which could be a constant or any other univariate variable. Although there is no accepted standard notation, it is a common practice to denote scalar constants with Greek characters such as alpha, beta, gamma, etc., and scalar variables with lowercase English alphabets. Scalar variables can be real or complex. For machine learning, limiting our discussion to real-valued scalars would suffice. So henceforth, the scalar quantities we use will belong to the set of real numbers. We just learned that in machine learning, most models are multivariate. But the vital tunable variables, the so-called hyperparameters, are usually scalars. The success, downfall, and reproducibility of machine learning algorithms hinge on these hyperparameters. So scalars might look simple, but they are important. A vector is an ordered list of scalars. A vertical vector is known as a column vector. A horizontal one is known as a row vector. To indicate that a vector is a bigger container than a scalar, the vector notation uses bold-faced characters. In mathematical and physical disciplines, where we actually care about directions, there is also an arrow above the character to denote that the entity faces a certain way. But this is unusual in machine learning literature. A row vector can be transformed into a column vector and vice versa with the transpose operator. It is denoted by the superscript T on the vector being transposed. In machine learning, a feature vector is a vector containing multiple elements about an object. For example, to represent the intensity of a set of pixels in a two-dimensional image. Suppose we have this image, 0 denotes black pixels and 1 denotes white pixels. The feature vector containing the intensity of each pixels of this object can be represented as this vector. Now, this numerical representation of the image can be fed to your machine learning algorithm for processing and analysis. In spam detection algorithms, where you classify if an email is spam or not, features may include the presence or absence of certain email headers or the frequency of specific terms. This composite representation of multiple vectors is known as a matrix. Its components are now identified by two indices, I and j. I represents the index to the matrix row, while j represents the index to the matrix column. Each component of the matrix is identified by A, I, j. This is an m cross n matrix, as it contains m rows and n columns. The full m cross n matrix can be written as: each horizontal list of elements is known as a row of the matrix. For example, the elements a11, a12, so on a1n form the first row of the matrix A. Note that a row vector is a size 1 cross n matrix, since it has one row and n columns. Similarly, each vertical list of elements is known as a column of the matrix. The elements a11, a21, and so on am1 form the first column of the matrix A. The column vector is a size m cross 1 matrix, since it has m rows and one column. Naturally, the diagonal or the list of elements from the top left to the bottom right are known as the diagonal of the matrix. The elements a11, a22, a33, so on ann form the diagonal of the matrix A. In deep learning, neural network weights are stored as matrices, but we won't discuss more about that in this video. Tensors can be a bit tricky to understand at this point, so we won't discuss it in much detail today, but I want you to have this concept of tensor somewhere in your mind. We have already seen that a more general entity of tensor encapsulates the scalar, vector, and the matrix. In a general case, an array of numbers arranged on a regular grid with a variable number of axes is known as a tensor. It is the main data structure used to handle deep learning data. For example, if we have this two-dimensional cat image that looks like a Pokemon, a third-order tensor can be used to describe the intensity values of multiple channels that are red, green, and blue. We will go into more details about tensors in later videos when we start deep learning. One last thing before ending this video, let's come back to this frame. Can you notice that this 3D tensor is a generalized representation of matrix, vector, and scalar data types? The scalar is a 0D tensor, vector is a 1D tensor, matrix is a 2D tensor, and the tensor shown here is a 3D tensor, since an extra dimension depth is also there in a tensor. Usually, tensor refers to a 3 or more dimensional data type. There can be 4D tensors, 5D tensors, or 6D tensors. A 3D tensor can be used to represent time series data or a single RGB color image, as we did. A 4D tensor can be used to represent a set of images. 5D tensor is used to represent videos. And we will learn about more higher dimensional tensors if needed in later videos. Thanks for your time. Have a nice day.